Welcome to week four of the Reading Rocket Patriot Team football. Rockets have started out strong this season with a 3-0 start, but this week may be the test of the year for the boys. Drake, it was the only team to beat this Rocket B team last year. A very tight 7-6 regular season loss and an unfortunate walloping during the playoffs to end our season. Drake gets known to show some unconventional formations, but more importantly, they have some really talented skill position players who are excellent. Their website indicates they're 2-1 this year. They took a big loss to Acton Boxborough, 48-20, but the Rockets are going to have payback on their mind this week as we head up to Drake. Joe, we're going to have to try to keep it short tonight. They only gave us 43 minutes. It's going to be very hard for
Talk
me
fast.
After last night's social. All right, we'll see you later. Back. All right, here's the kickoff right now. Back deep, it looks like number 22, Dan Damari. Dan, the cut's left behind Stevie Needham, and he gets wrapped up right around the 42-yard line. Tough to see. There's no thanks. All right, first and 10 here for the Rockets to start the game at their own 40 after the run back by Damari. Back deep is Dom DiCrescenzo, and it looks like Jay Kajander back as well. Dom right behind Jay, and he puts his head down, but he gets met immediately. So nice job to stack up and actually drop him for a loss. All right, second down, and call it just a little bit more than 10. The ground and pound team of DiCrescenzo and Lucas Fleming is switched up to this week because Fleming is out with that ankle injury.
It's a big loss, Tim. Good combination.
Yep, there's Dom again. He goes left, and then he's got a big hole there. So Domi takes that for about four, and you're going to be looking at third and six upcoming. Here we go. It's third and seven now here for the Rockets on their first set. Big play right here early in the game. Direct snap to Kajander. This time he follows Dom. He puts his head down, gets about three or four more, but it's going to be fourth and four upcoming. You might see the Rockets try to play field position here and kick it away. All right, here we go. It is fourth down here. Just about midfield, and it looks like Troy is going to be back to kick this thing. Pollock back. Oh, there's an offsides that could have got them. Oh, and they throw the flag anyway. That's going to be five, and that could be a first down for Reading. That's a huge play right there if he gained 5 yards. And they look like they're calling it on Reading. They say we might have moved, and they're moving us back five. I thought he threw it the other way. They jumped off, and there we go. So now we're going to be kicking again. Here we go. Troy Pollock back. Troy gives it a boot right now. It's a good kick, and it gets away from him. Scooped up by number 13. He's got a seam right there, and he gets hammered by Jay Kajander over there and Dom DiCrescenzo. Both of those guys put a lick on him, and it's going to be first down coming for Drake. All right, first and 10 here for Drake. Look for number 41 and number 12, their quarterback. Good athletes. This guy, number 13, I think I remember him from last year, too, but 41 is their big running back. It's a direct snap to 13. He goes off tackle, but he gets met immediately. Let's see who was in on that tackle. Dom DiCrescenzo came in. Who else was on there? Danny Damari. Second and call at nine here for the Rockets. A big defensive line in there. Stack tight formation. Direct snap to number 41. He gets met immediately. Number 11, I think that was Troy coming in on the outside and stuffed him for a loss. So beautiful play by Troy Pinchin. I think it was a blitz right there. He plays usually free safety. Great play there by Troy and Stevie Needham. Here we go, third and 11 here. This is a big play for this for the Rockets. See if they can get the ball back here with some field position. A couple of big bodies on that Drake at line, Joe.
They're a good team, Tim. We know that.
Direct snap. It's a handoff to 41. He cuts up. He slips, though, on the grass. Right in there again is Damari to make a play and close a hole, but he slipped on the grass. And look for Drake to kick this thing away now. Here we are, fourth and 12. Number 41 is back to kick. Back deep is Troy Pollock to receive. High snap, he makes a nice play. Lefty boot right there. I think this one might go out of bounds, and it does. So it gets out of bounds probably around the 35-yard line for the Rockets where they'll take over. Joe, we're running out of time here, so we're going to try to keep it short in the first one. Then we're going to save some time for some nonsense later, okay?
Okay.
Perfect. First and 10 here for the Rockets. It looks like about their 37-yard line. It's hard to see. There's no markings on the field itself here. A little bit of rain overnight, too. Kajander DiCrescenzo back, just like the first series, right to Dom. He goes off tackle. That's actually behind Beckett, who's at Dom. He's at the room. He breaks that thing for a first. He's a big body. He cuts back. That's a first down right at midfield for DiCrescenzo. First and 10 for the Rockets right around midfield. That was behind Sean Beckenhuis on that play. Domi found a seam and almost broke that thing. Looks like Troy Pollock in there now. Pollock's going to follow. Oh, look at Pollock. He's got moves. He switches the hands, and he's too fast. And there goes Troy. He's got the wheels. We saw it last year. And Troy takes one 50 yards for a touchdown. He broke two long ones the other day, Joe. And Troy found the seam up the middle, cuts right, and he can't be caught.
Good they're finding those holes up the middle, Tim. And if he, once he gets to the outside, he's gone.
I'll tell you, he's a small guy, and clearly, though, he's got the wheels because he's got breakaway speed, even with the fastest D-backs that they have. So beautiful play by Troy. We probably won't show our extra point to save some time early, Joe, so we'll come back for the kickoff. Here's the kickoff for Domi DiCrescenzo. The Rockets did not convert. It's a deep kick. It goes to number 12 here. The quarterback, he drops it. That's a blind ball right there. In comes Troy to cut him off, but he's got some room, and he's got a seam. Looks like a block in the back, though. That's going to happen. He finally gets taken down by number 73 is Patrick DeRoss, and it's going to be on Drakett, so it's going to push him back a little bit. There was a read option that Troy did and didn't get in, so the Rockets are up 6-0. Troy did it the last time too, Joe. First time he touched the ball in the game, he breaks one for a long touchdown. He does it again 2 weeks in a row. First and 10 here for Drakett after the penalty. Pushing back just inside their own 20. They got some big boys on that line. Coach running out to get the tee and cost us some precious seconds of hearing my own voice. Inside, it's a pass outside to 41. Troy's right there. Nice play for Troy. He gets stacked up. He's still on his feet, though.
Good
athletic play to get off of Troy, but a little bit pushed out there. Number 52 is in there, Mason Dion, but it's going to be second and close to first down. Let's call it second and two here. Very different look right here, spread offense. Inside handoff there, gets met immediately by Sean Beckenhuis and then gets piled on by DiCrescenzo and Dion. Beautiful play right there to push him back. Third and call it five after the pushback by Beckenhuis. Nice play to stay home for Sean on that line. Same formation. This one he's going to look like to throw. He goes back, he lays it out to number 57. Kajander trying to move over. He gets wrapped up immediately by number 44 is Stevie Needham, and I think they stopped him short. It's fourth and one, and this is going to be a tough call for them. I think you'd have to kick for field position.
I think field position, absolutely. These are two very balanced teams, and field position is critical.
All right, look for them to kick coming up. Fourth and two, and they're setting up here as if they're not going to kick it.
They're going.
They're going to go for it here.
Good opportunity.
And this is a very, very big play right here if they're going for it. And he's going to try to kick it, and I don't think he can get away from it. Oh, no, he breaks off the kick.
He had a flag,
and he's and he oh, he's. I think there's a flag that's going to bring him back, but great play. Nice eyes there, Joe. Over there is number 52, Dion, 41, Beckenhuis, but it looks like they're going to push it back, and now you might definitely see them kick. I think he tried to kick, Joe. The Rockets were on him so quickly, he had to pull it down.
I think you're right.
He ran it for the first down. But now it's going to come back.
Go.
Fourth down here, and I think you're definitely going to see him kick here, Joe. It was an illegal formation. They didn't have enough guys on the line, so they threw the flag immediately. Kid made an athletic play to get what would have been the first. The penalty says no. They're spreading this wide. Let me see if he's going to try to kick this. No, he pulls it down again. Oh, he's got some room, though. Let's see if Damari closes on him. Danny takes him down, and they're going to turn the ball over on downs. It's a beautiful play, but there's another flag. I think it might be another legal formation here, but we'll see what goes. All right, first and 10 here for the Rockets. They take over with great field position. Beautiful defensive front there. Jake Kajander's been on fire. He throws it. Oh, he pulls it down, Troy. And now he throws it out. He's wide open out here. It's 81. That's Kenyon. Oh, he fumbles the ball, and he fumbles it out of bounds, though. So fortunate bounce for the Rockets. Kenyon pulls down the pass. After Troy makes an athletic play to get around it, it's going to be a first down. And the Rockets get great field position around the 10. And at the 15-yard line, Joe, I tell you, Troy pulled that one down, and he still had time and two guys wide open.
It's a good sign having men open, Tim.
There we go. Troy's going to pull this one down. He pulls it down again. He gets outside. It looks like there's going to be a block in the back, though. It's going to move him back. Unfortunately, Troy is still on his feet, gets pulled out of bounds, but it looks like we're going to move this one back. First and 20 here for the Rockets after the 10-yard penalty. Different formation here. Split right is DiCrescenzo. Behind Pollock is Damari. Hands off to Damari up the middle. Danny finds a seam. He cuts back. He's still on his feet. Beautiful play and another flag down, though. We got to see where this goes. down again here. Another penalty, and the two holding penalties in a row. I didn't see either one of those, Joe. I'll have to take a look at the tape later. Different formation here. Look like we get Needham split. DiCrescenzo and Pollock with Damari behind him. It's a fake to here. It's underneath, and it's just a low pass. Domi DiCrescenzo is the guy. It's going to be second and 25 here for the Rockets after a couple pushbacks. Incomplete pass in the last one. Out left, Trev Conroy. It's a pitch to Damari, who cuts up, and he gets met almost immediately. So it's going to be for a loss or a no gain right there. And it's going to be third and long coming up. Third down, 25 here. Definite four down territory here, Joe. Drakett's big player, number 41, just went off shaking his hand. So nice to see him out of the game. He's one of the top players. DiCrescenzo, and he's trying to get him in motion. Damari goes in motion. It's going to be a pass to Troy. Troy pulls it down. He sees a seam. He breaks off a tackle, but nice job right there by number 12, their quarterback, to bring Troy down after a gain of about just a couple. And so it's going to be fourth down here, but you'll see him go for it. All right, fourth down here for the Rockets. They're going to go for it at the 30-yard line. DiCrescenzo in motion. It's going to be Troy back to pass. He throws it underneath to Damari. He's got some room. Oh, he just slips. And Danny's mad at himself, but he slips on the wet grass. I'm going to turn the ball over on downs. First down on the turnover there. Danny Damari had some room in front of him, and the slick field cost him in this grass field, Joe. We got a penalty right here already. We'll come back and see what it is. Picking up the flag right here. It would say too many men in the huddle on that one. So immediate 5-yard penalty. Here we go. It's the inside handoff to big number 13. And he's got some blockers ahead of him. Nice play right there by Troy to clip him and push him out. But he had a nicely set up play. Some big guys in front of him. Troy weaved through and knocked him out. So beautiful play by Pollock. Here we go. It's going to be second and about 10 right now. They get five back in that play. Beautiful play by Pollock. In motion, 41. That's their big runner. And he's going to keep it himself and throw it up in the middle. Oh, Troy intercepts it. He jumps it, and Pollock jumps in and takes it. And he's got some room up the side. Troy spied that one out. Beautiful play. And they are all piled on top. He's in. He's in for the touchdown. Oh, boy, what a play by Pollock to spy it out. Jumps the route and takes it up the right-hand seam for a touchdown. His second one of the day. Troy doing it on offense and defense today. Beautiful play by Pollock. We'll come right back after the extra point. Domi DiCrescenzo with the kickoff. They missed the extra point. That's a live ball right there. Number 41, their biggest player, best player, picks it up. Gets immediately strung out. Drives it forward and meets DiCrescenzo head on. Might be Oki right in the middle of that thing, too. He put his head down. Oak takes him down. It's going to be first and 10 upcoming. Rockets up 12 to nothing. We're getting close to the second half, Joe. Here we go. First and 10 from the 45-yard line. It was a short kick by DiCrescenzo. First and 10, pretty good field position here. I formation, it's a new look for them. Handoff right up the gut to 41, or for the 30, and he takes it for about 3 or 4. Second and 8 upcoming right now for Drakett. Same I formation. Oh, they moved, and they're going to move this back 5 yards, and we're going to do it again. Here we are, it's going to be second and call at 13 or 14 now after the false start. Rocket D has done well today so far. Some good skill position players on Drakett. They haven't been able to make one convert. It's going to be a pass now, and he's got a guy open. He overthrows him by a mile. So that's an incomplete pass. It's going to be third and 13 coming up. Go. It's going to be third and 13 here. Big play for the Rockets. We don't know how much time's left in the half, so we're not sure if this is at midfield, if it would be four down territory. It's going to be a pass again. He loads it underneath. Number 13 jumps and gets it. He's got room ahead of him. Beautiful play by Pollock to keep him out, to knock him down. But it's going to be a first down here. So nicely set up play. And number 13, I remember him from last year. He's a big kid. Pulls it in, and Troy makes probably a touchdown-saving tackle there. Just heard the referee yell is 2 minutes and 30 seconds and running time right now. I formation. Going to be a pitch out here to number 13. What a play. He gets in there. Kajander. And then he gets crunched by number 73 as DeRoss. Doesn't quite knock him out. He gets stacked up. But I'll tell you, Jay Kajander had a monster game last week, Joe. And he was in there again and pushed him back. So we're probably getting close to the 2-minute warning right here. All right, call it second and 12 right here after the great pushback. But good pursuit by Kajander. Gets cleaned up. Pat DeRoss in there. So is Dominic. Three guys in the backfield here. Looks like someone moved on the left. It's going to be number 13. He's got a couple blockers in front of him. Oh, Troy gets caught up, and that's what he's got daylight in front of him. Last guy is Needham, and Needham knocks him out at the 10-yard line. So Troy got tripped up. He usually spies that one out. Stevie Needham knocks him out. But that's a huge run right before the end of the half here, and this one's going to be tight here at the end of the half, Joe. Quickly break the huddle here. They want to get right to it. It's going to be inside. Looks like first and goal here, close to the 10. Big run by number 13 following number 41. It's going to be a power inside handoff to number 57. He's still on his feet. He just gets about 6 yards or so. He's very close to the touchdown. They stop him right before it. I want to see who's in there. Maybe Damari. Oki in there as well. So it's going to be first. Let's see. Second and goal. All right, second and goal here for Drakett at the end of the first half. It's a keeper by 12 right up the middle. He tries to follow his guy, and he's in. So number 12 goes in. They're going to make it 12-6 right now before the half. We'll see if Drake can convert on the extra. All right, we're going to show this one because there's a kick right here. It's going to be a two-point conversion if they kick it. So we're going to show this one. It's a nice kick, and it is a bomb. Wow, this kick was booted, and that's a huge play right there, Joe, to make it 12-8. So now they're within a score right now, so that kick can really boot the ball. I haven't seen too many kids at this level kick like that.
College ready, Boston College.
Beautiful play right there, and that's a huge extra point for Drake to get it within a score, and we'll see how much time is left in the half. Nice boot here. It's going to be over Troy's head. Troy pulls it in around the 10. He's looking for a blocker. He does fall. See him. He sees it. Oh, nice. He is shifty, man. I'll tell you. He finally gets caught back after about a 15-yard gain, and the Rockets are going to take over from the 30-yard line. First and 10 here for the Rockets. Damari in the backfield now with Pollock out. The thumb is hurt. He hands it off to Big Dom, and Dom rumbles. Gets hit hard, and there's going to be a flag here. He might push it back. We'll see where that goes, but let's see if it's against the Rockets. First and let's call it 17. They pushed him back on a hold. I don't know if it would be right off 10 yards from the line of scrimmage, but Troy is back in the game. Damari flanking him. He's going to go back and pass, and he throws it up to Domi, and Domi gets it. Oh, he pulls it in. He makes the grab. So beautiful. Oh, he doesn't make it. It bounces. So it looks like from here that he made the catch, but it was a little bit of a wobbly pass, but DiCrescenzo came down with it and then ended up dropping at the end, so it's going to be, look like second and 17. All right, second down here after the incomplete pass. Let's see if Troy and Damari are in the backfield. Split right is Beckenhue. Split left, Evan Tice. Trevor Conroy split far right. Now we get a whistle here, and it might be someone looking for a call of timeout. All right, they're conferring what the spot was on that particular ball. In motion is Beckenhues. Goes direct. Oh, looks like Troy was going to put down almost like it was a pooch punt on the third, but he gets pulled down. It's going to be third down. Now what Troy wanted to do, Beckenhues left in the half on third down here. You may just see Troy sort of kneel this thing out and then see if they can boot it or run around a little bit and kill the clock and get to the half with the lead. And Roy actually keeps it himself. Troy cuts back. Gets about 4 or 5 yards. I think that's going to do it in the half, and we'll find out, Joe, after this. The last play of the half here, Joe, is about just seconds on the clock. There were 9 before that one. It can only be 2 or 3, but they used their last timeout. Tyson motion. It's going to go to Troy. Troy's just going to keep it. Going to get outside. Wow, if he gets it blocked there, he has somebody. He runs it out of bounds. That should be the end of the half here, Joe, with the Rockets up 12-8. Got Foxy in to kick off now for the second half. Picked up by number 41, their big player. Puts his head down. He's still on his feet. He's a tough guy to bring down, but he gets brought down. Kajander at Beckenhuson there about midfield. Okay, it's going to be first down here for Drakett. Just about their 46-yard line. It's going to be a pass. Kajander is all over him. So is Dorman. He throws it out just to save himself. Takes a big hit. Jay right in there as well as DiCrescenzo. Starting the second half here. Hey, listen, I was just listening to Jill Damari and Robin Pollock in front of us. They were talking about us, Joe.
Were they?
Yeah, yeah. They were talking about America's Top Model.
Yes,
the show absolutely. They were watching last night.
Yeah.
So we were on there.
Next week we're on.
A couple of great parents in front of us. Paul DeRoss is here again. And he is absolutely ripped at me for calling him slow last week. But we're going to have a 50-yard dash in the second half. Bill Cronin's here. A lot of people don't know that Bill is he's actually a clog dancing expert.
Is he?
Yeah.
What size clogs?
I read that in Wikipedia, I think, but that has to be confirmed. What size? I know. What are the size clogs Bill Cronin has to wear?
Special
massive.
Made.
Here we are. Second down here after the short play. We'll try to sneak in some little fun here. We have no time in the clock. This is that type of formation we saw last year. We don't know who it goes to. Stop right at the middle. Oh, boy. Gets stopped immediately. In there is going to be 44 Stevie Needham. Domi DiCrescenzo on the bottom of the pile is number 10, Lynchy. Third and 8 here after the nice play up the middle. We saw that formation a lot last year, Joe.
Yeah, you don't know who's going to get the ball. It's difficult
That's
to defend.
Right. Looked like some movement there, but they're going to keep it. It's a tough snap. Gets caught up there, right there. Nice move to stay in his feet, but they get stacked up and they stop him. So it's going to be 4th and 9. Midfield, this is going to be a tough call here. But you know what, Joe? This game's a lot closer than it should be. It looks like Reading had this game really in hand and in control. And a huge play, and that extra point was huge. Getting back to Bill Cronin. Sean Cronin's his son, number 64, first-year player. Funniest movie you've seen? Sausage Party.
Never saw it, Tim.
Yeah, well, I'm going to have to talk to the Cronins about that because I think it's NC-17, that one. So big trouble for them.
That's why I never saw it.
Fourth down, number 41 back here. Looks like they're going to be – we'll see if they're going to try to kick this thing. They don't give it away. It could be a direct snap here to number 12, but 41 could take it and boot it. And he pulls it down, throws it underneath, and what a play by Stevie Needham to turn
Stevie
it over.
Needham.
Spied that out. It was a good-looking play,
excellent.
And Needham came over and make a spectacular defensive play. Needham's another guy that Oki talked about earlier in the year who's really stepped it
up. Team's fired up now, Tim.
Great play on the first series here, and the Rockets going to take over midfield. First and 10 here for the Rockets. DiCrescenzo is back at with Sean Beckenhuis. Goes to Domi, he follows out. Oh, he cut a little seam there, puts his head down. What a, drives it for a quick 6 or 7. Nice job, it's gonna be 2nd and 4. We go 2nd and call it 4 here. Looks like it's a direct snap to Troy. He cuts outside, he's got a little bit of room. Oh, nice, puts his head right in and gets run out of bounds. Oh, maybe a little extracurricular there for a penalty, but getting back to Sean Cronin, his favorite is a female celebrity, Jennifer Lawrence.
Good choice, right? Sean. Good choice.
Yeah, what was that? What was the big thing he was in? Hunger Games, right?
Hunger Games, and she was in...
Speaking of that, I just had 2 of the worst cheeseburgers I've ever had in my life, Joe.
Sustenance.
Oh, my God. It was awful. This is what happens when we get these 2 o'clock games, right? We miss the Patriots, but it makes it all worth it if the Rockets win. So we're going to be 3rd and call 3 here. All right, it's going to 3rd and 3 here. We got Damari behind him. This could be a passing situation. Kenyon in motion. It's a handoff to Danny. He's got some room. Nice play. First down. Amari breaks it. Danny might get it. He might get outside. I think it's pulled down at the end. A huge run by Damari. Rips it for a first down.
Great
gets down
to
about
the
15-yard line. Beautiful run. He sees the hole. You know what? Danny Damari, both offensively and defensively, can spy a hole and hit it very quickly. Almost took that one to the house.
Seems to be a second-half player.
Beautiful. Here from just inside the 20 after the great run by Damari. Pollock under center for this one. Looks like we have Damari back deep. Oh, the ball almost fumbled. Then Troy picks it up and actually gains a yard or two. It's going to be 2nd and 8. Back behind Troy is Damari, conferring with each other right now. Kenyon split left. Kenyon goes in motion. It's going to be a handoff to Danny. Up the middle, he finds another hole, and he gets wrapped up very quickly, so he gets a couple of yards, and it's called 3rd down upcoming, maybe 6 or 7. Call this one 3rd and 6 right here for the Rockets. Deep in, right around the 15-yard line. Under center is Pollock. He's going to keep it. He's going to throw out. Throws out to Domi, and he's got place ahead of him. Oh, boy, put your head down there, Dom. And he takes it. He's still not going down, and he might be in.
Very, very close.
Nice play out underneath. Goes to DiCrescenzo. He takes it very close to the goal line, but that's a first down for the Rockets. Here we go. It's 1st and goal here from the 1-yard line. DiCrescenzo very close to getting in. Pollock under center. He keeps himself off tackle, and is he in?
Yes.
He is in. They give it to him. So Troy gets his second one of the day, or his third one of the day, right?
Right.
He had two offensive and one defensive now. Troy goes in, and that's much needed breathing room for the Rockets. Huge play by Damari. Great play by DeCrescenzo off a nice pass from Pollock. And we're going to see what happens after the extra point. Redding going to try to kick this one. Troy Pollock in there. Oh, he was on top. Look at Troy. He picks it up. And it looks like guys all over him, but he might just get in there. Oh, he gets pulled down from behind. That's a horse collar. That's going to be a penalty on the extra point. They might be able to do it again here. But the guys were all over him for the kick, looking for two, and it's going to be a penalty, and they get to probably get to do this one more time. Let's give it another shot here. Rockets line are going to have to do better than that. Troy kicks it and does get blocked in the back, so let's just stop right there. The Rockets are going to be up 18-8, getting close to the end of the third quarter. Big kickoff return. That's something the Rockets got to work on, Joe. They had two kickoff returns that Drake had got. Great field position here. They start off inside about 35. Oh, he didn't know what to do. He throws it underneath, and it's a low pass, but he gets dropped up by Troy. So a couple of points there, but we're talking about the kickoff returns. They had one kicked off for a touchdown against them last year. Two big here. That's something I'm sure the coaches are going to take a look at on film.
Long week for the boys. Go.
All right, here we go. It's second down and call it maybe six. About the 30-yard line, 32-yard line. It's going to be a pass here. Oh, number 41's right there. Who's on him? Oki was right in on him. Get a push here. Nice job. Oki forces him back, runs him out, and DeCrescenzo cleans up. So came in from the backside was Beckenhuis. Oki with great pursuit, and DeCrescenzo cleans him up on the sideline. Third and call it 18 right here after the pushback. Great play by Beckenhuis, O'Connor, and DeCrescenzo there. Look for a pass here. He is going to try to pass it. Number 12, Lorenzo and Quirk. There's Kajander outside. And Jay Kajander sheds his blocker and makes a huge play. It's going to be fourth. No gain right there. So Jay Kajander did a nice job of not getting sealed off and shuts him down.
Pursuing.
Here we go. Big fourth down play here. They look like they're going to kick, but don't look for that. Look for him to keep it. He does pull it down.
O'Connor.
Right here, it's Evan Tice. Puts a big hit on Moki in there,
big
too.
Play.
Great play by Evan Tice to stay home. It was Sean Beckenhuis in there, too. And then Oak comes up and cleans him up on fourth down and turns it over. So the Rockets, huge play on fourth down. Close him up, and they're going to take over first
good
and 10 from close to midfield. Rockets take over here. Great field position there. Awesome defense on that last series. Goes right up the middle to Damari. Big hole. Danny cuts
good
back.
Dance.
He's shifty.
Nice.
He's still on his feet. Wow, Danny rips that off for close to a first down. Might be, but good 9-10 yards on first down into Drake territory. Here we go. Rocket coaching staff fired up over here saying a guy was on the ground and Drake, a player, thought he speared him with his helmet.
The ref apparently gave him a warning. I don't know
here
why.
Here we go. It's Troy keeps it up the middle. He's shifty. Troy's still on his feet. Oh! He drives. He gets the first down, though. And this is some great yardage right here. Getting first down in the fourth quarter.
So just chew up the clock. Get some first down.
Chewing it up. Hey, we talked earlier about how bad the cheeseburgers were here. How about a cheeseburger eating contest? I'm not talking about the kids.
Oh,
who do you think the parents would win with?
Oh,
Paul DeRoss could throw a few back.
Yeah.
How about Steve DeCrescenzo and Richie Marshallsee? How about the coaching staff, Damari, Marshallsee, and Gilligan?
I think we'll check Vegas, see if there's
any
odds.
Oh, my God. How many? I bet you they could eat between the three of them 29 cheeseburgers.
I'd say we'll take a financial
29.
Loss. Pop Warner doesn't have that kind
maybe
of budget.
Maybe more. Here we go. Right here, Troy right in the middle. Let's Domi. Domi gets a couple and gets stacked up, and they blow the whistle. So it's going to be second and nine upcoming. Call it second and nine right here. Rocket coaching staff still fired up. Thought there was a... It's a hand. Oh, it's going to be a pass. There's a flag right now. Throws it underneath to Patrick DeRoss, is wide open. And unfortunately, it's a beautifully set up play. It might be coming back. Oh, first and 10. Beautiful pass and catch by Pollock and DeRoss. And it was actually an offsides against them. So I should have been a little bit more excited. Sitting here next to Paul DeRoss, he's jumping up and down like he just went the lottery. Here we go. Troy keeps it out left. He gets outside. Nice pursuit by number 18 to pull him down. Tough tackle, but Troy does get a couple out of it. It's going to be second and eight. We go second and eight right now after the short carry by Pollock. Damari next to flank Pollock. Three guys out wide. He's going to throw it underneath.
Got a whistle.
And there's a whistle. Might have had some movement that's going to move the Rockets back five, Joe. The Rockets up 18-8.
I think they've calmed down.
Different. They don't know where they're going, the formation here. Three guys split left. It's direct to Troy. He keeps it right up the middle, and he's got wheels. Oh, Troy just gets pulled down, but he gains it. That's going to be a first down.
That's the key, first down.
First down for Troy. He pulls it up. He sees a huge seam. That was a play by design. They set it up for a pass on the earlier one. They called back. They stacked the three left. He takes it up the middle for a first down. First and 10 here for the Rockets. They could get another first down. It's just outside the 10. Maybe call it the 13-yard line. In motion's Tice. Direct snap goes to Damari. Damari cuts out left, but they close quickly on him. So nice play by the D there. And like I said, things are getting a little heated up there. I think the Drake players getting frustrated because the Rockets are controlling the clock and they're up 10 here late in the game. It's going to be second down, in about 10 here. To no gain. Three stacked left. Here's Troy. Same play up the middle again. He gains a couple. He gets down to about the 10-yard line. And it's going to be third and about eight, maybe seven. 2:38 and counting right here. So, Joe, we did the world's greatest job of conserving some tape here. Nonsense. Here goes Troy back to throw. He keeps it. Oh, there's going to be a flag on the Rockets, and he gets pushed way back. So I don't know if they're going to take
this.
That's
a late hit right there. Oh, maybe he just fell.
We'll see what happens on this play upcoming. Here we go. It's 4th and 17 after the pushback here. Rockets at about the 20-yard line here. You might see the Rockets just hand the ball off and try to run the clock down. And Troy's going to be back to throw. He's got a seam there. Troy's going to take it himself, and let's see if he can get caught. He's shifty. He does get caught, so they are going to turn the ball over on downs, but he keeps it in bounds, and the clock is ticking here. So with under 2 minutes to go, we're going to get to, hey, number 10's right here, Lynchy, right?
His favorite food's
a cheeseburger, if you can believe it. You know his favorite female celebrity? Kate Upton.
Kate Upton, good
She
choice.
Might be one of mine, too,
yeah.
Right? Paul DeRoss is over here licking his chops like he just ate a cheeseburger. I just said Kate Upton, his eyes bulged out of his head. So he wants Bill Belichick to be president. That's another
choice.
Guy, right? And his funniest movie he's ever seen, Ted 2.
That's a good choice.
Yeah.
Movie. Okay.
Does anyone know these kids are 13 years old?
Yeah.
And those are NC. Those are
my son, I think so.
Those are R-rated movies? Okay.
Yeah.
All right, here we are. They take over here. They're going to have to come up with a bag of tricks here. Three guys split way left here. He throws it out. This might be a double pass here. They're going to try it. 13's up there. Troy's up there. Pulls his head. Oh, he pulls it down. Wow, right there, Patrick DeRoss. He pushes him off too, so he's on his feet. He's going to take it to the house. Wow, the double pass was defended well by Troy. Number 13 pulls it down, and Pat DeRoss catches him, but he bounces off of DeRoss, and he takes it to the house, and that is the type of score they needed immediately. So 18-14, you may see these guys try that kick again.
That's right.
To
with
get
that,
within three, and that kid can
that
kick
can
the
kick
ball.
Kick a field goal, yeah.
Wow, that is a huge play by Drake it right there. And it was one that we spied out early, Joe. Looked like the double pass. Troy had good coverage. 13 made a great play. And DeRoss couldn't bring him down at the very end, and he takes it in. Number 31's going to go for two. This kid could really kick the ball.
We did block one earlier.
He actually is moving it back a little bit. This hit such a good kick, it'd give him more time. Oh, and he gets blocked right there up the middle.
It's
John DeCrescenzo. That's a huge block to keep it at four. It's now only a touchdown's going to do it. So great play by Darmy to get in there with his hands up in the air. 18-14 Rockets with about a minute and a half to go. Hey, number 8 is Trevor Conroy. His favorite food, Cajun chicken pasta from Chili's. That is awesome.
Nice.
He turned our whole family onto that. Me and Dan go down there and just stuff our faces with it. It's a must.
You need a lot of Coors Light.
There's only 74,000 grams of sodium in that, too. So I think it's actually can actually give you high blood pressure from just two eatings.
Yeah. The doctor right outside
his
the
favorite
door?
Female celebrity, Jennifer Lopez.
Oh,
my
choice.
God. Paul DeRoss is up here, his eyes bulging again. I said, Kate Upton to Jennifer Lopez. He's pumped. Psyched. His favorite movie, Superbad. Also an unbelievably inappropriate movie for 13-year-old
kids.
Well,
I think the standards are different today.
So these guys are all fired up. Hey, look, they got all these guys up. They don't care if the ball goes deep here. They're going to let these guys, they're going to expect the onside kick, which is there. There's Troy right there. Troy pounces on it. Nice play by Troy. They expect the onsides. They did it. Rockets are going to take over here with under a minute to go. It was 105 at the kickoff, probably right at the 1 minute mark. Rockets up 18-14. Back to Trev. Who we'd like to be present? Will Ferrell.
Not bad.
That guy's hilarious, isn't he?
Yeah.
He'd like to be. Okay, that's good. All right, it's going to be first down here for the Rockets around the 41-yard line. Joe, I think you might have missed the entire awesome play from Drake it with your terrible camera work.
Well, yeah.
Troy's going to keep it. He gets outside.
I got this.
Troy's going to want to stay in bounds. Oh, he gets pushed out of bounds by number 12. I think Troy was thinking of trying to stay in bounds to run the clock down. But the clock will stop, and it's going to be second about eight. I'm out left, Joe, and I think Troy tried to stop himself to stay in bounds there, but they get pushed out. So the clock did stop. We got to be under a minute. That's Tyson motion. Troy hands it right up the middle of Damari. Danny's got more feet. Just slips to the end when he tries to cut back, but that's exactly what we need, and they call timeout immediately. So while they have it, let's go down here, number 71 right here. Close to your own heart there is Pat Dwyer, right? Son of cameraman. What do they say? In French, they say terrible.
Terrible?
Yeah.
Isn't that terrible?
No, it doesn't mean that, Joe. Okay. You have to look that up. But you know what? If Pat could be any animal, you want to be a sloth.
A sloth.
I have it on good authority. He already is.
Yeah.
Right?
And then
his favorite movie, Old School.
Yeah. It's highly inappropriate.
What's funny is we were at the social last night, and I recall a couple of different people from the Running Pop Warner social running down Grove Street naked. They were streaking. Streaking afterwards.
Was one of them you, Tim?
I there's no film of it. That's all I'll say. Thank God for all of us. Chris's favorite. Here we are. Chris Pratt is his favorite male celebrity, right? Favorite female. He's going right for the comedy favorite female. Amy Poehler.
How
about that? She's funny. Burlington's own too.
Yeah.
Right in our backyard.
Local girl. Looking her up.
Hey, we got third and about five here. The Rockets get a first down, and this thing's going to be over. I don't think they won't be able to stop the clock here. DeCrescenzo and Troy Pollock back. Troy has done an unbelievable job today without Lucas Fleming. He's got most of the snaps here. He takes it outside. He cuts back in, close to the first down, but more importantly, they're going to run the clock down. So
might
it's going to be
a little time left. It's
going to be fourth down, and I think obviously over 50, you're just going to see him run it again. Fourth and two for the Rockets here. 45 seconds. If they get a first down, this game is going to be over. It's a handoff up the middle of Damari, and he gets stopped. So they get the ball back, they stop Damari, and they are going to get a chance offensively from midfield. So great defensive stop from Draken, and this game is not over. 18-14, 40 seconds to go here, and look for something that they're going to try to pull something out of their bag of tricks right here. Here we go. They have it here. We have less than a minute on our own clock here. We got to get this game, and they throw it. He's going to try the double throw again. He gets run out of bounds. He dives out. Here's the snap back here. It's second down. He looks underneath. Big pursuit by O'Connor. Oki gets in there. Kajanda cleans him up. And DeCrescenzo. Great pursuit by Oki. DeCrescenzo and Kajanda get in there. We're going to stop the clock. Third and long here. It's going to be a pass. Oh, Beckett Hughes is here. He gets around him. Here comes Dormy to take an angle on him. He runs out of bounds. Last play of the game. We don't know if he got it. Big room there. Oh, he cuts back. He's still on his feet. Oh, Oki's in. He's held. Oki's held. He pulls it down.
Game time,
Oki does it. Game is over. And that's it. We're out of clock. See?